Today we shall learn more about anti-logarithms. It will be dealt in three parts: anti-log of integers, anti-log of positive non-integers, and finally anti-log of negative non-integers. So let us start with anti-log of integers. If x is an integer, then anti-log x is equals to 10 raised to the power x. Therefore, anti-log 0 is equals to 10 raised to the power 0, which is nothing but 1. Similarly, anti-log 1 is equals to 10 raised to the power 1. Anti-log 2 is equals to 10 raised to the power 2. Anti-log minus 1 is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 1. And anti-log minus 3 is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 3. Now let us switch over to anti-log of positive non-integers. Now we shall take another example, that is of anti-log of 0.4771. So here 0 is characteristic, and after the decimal we have 4771, that is mantissa. So after the decimal we have to take two digits. So here we have 47 as that number. So in front of 0.47, that is in the row of 0.47, under the column 7, which number is there? We have to search in the logbook. So under the tables of anti-logarithm, you'll find that the number is 2999. That number you have to note down. After that, the mean difference under the column 1. Why 1? Because here after 477, the number is 1. So under the column 1, under mean difference, which number is there? You have to find out. So that number is 1. So that 1 you have to add to 2999. So 2999 plus 1 is equals to 3000. That 3000 you have to write it as 3.000. That is, you have to place the decimal after the first digit from the left hand side. So 3000 becomes 3.000. Then you have to write into, then you have to write 10 raised to the power. So what is that power? So whatever the characteristic is there, that will become power of 10. So here in this example, characteristic is 0. Thus 3.000 into 10 raised to the power 0 is nothing but 3 into 1, which is nothing but 3. Thus anti-log 0.4771 is equals to 3. Now let us find out the anti-log of 0.3010. Here 0 is characteristic and 3010 is mantissa. So after the decimal, you take two digits. Here 30 are those numbers. In the row of 0.30, under the column 1, you see which number is there. So in the row of 0.30, under the column 1, 2000 number is there. That 2000 you have to write in the form of 2.000. That is, you have to put the decimal after the first digit from the left side. So that becomes 2.000. After that, into 10 raised to the power, whatever the characteristic is there, that you have to write. So in this case, 0 is the characteristic as shown by the arrow. So that 0 you have to write as power of 10. So 2.000 into 10 raised to the power 0. That is nothing but 2 into 1, or it is 2. Thus value of anti-log 0.3010 is 2. Now we shall find out the anti-log of 3.0913. Here 3 is characteristic and after the decimal we have 0913. It is mantissa. So after the decimal we have to take two digits. So here we have 09. So in front of 09, that is in the row of 09, in the logbook, under anti-logarithm tables, under the column 1. Why 1? Because after 09, the mantissa, there is 1. So in front of 0.09 or in the row of 0.09, under the column 1, you have to search which number is there. So that number is 1233. That number you have to note down, 1233. After that, under mean difference, under the column 3. Why 3? Because in the Mantissa after 0, 9 and 1, the next number is 3. So under the column 3, in the mean difference, which number is there you have to search in the logbook. So that number is 1. So that 1 you have to add to 1233. So it becomes 1234. This 1234, you have to write it as 1.234. That is, you have to place a decimal after the first digit from the left hand side. Thus 1234 becomes 1.234. After writing 1.234, you have to write into, and after that you have to write 10. And what is the power of 10, or what will be the power of 10? The power of 10 is nothing but whatever the characteristic is there. So here in this example, characteristic is 3. So 3 will become the power of 10. Thus the number becomes 1.234 into 10 raised to the power 3. So if you work out, it will give you 1234. Thus, antilog of 3.0913 is 1234. We shall take another example, antilog of 2.1234. So in the row of 0.12, under the column 3 in the logbook, under antilogarithm tables, the number will be 1327. Note down that number separately, 1327. Then under the column of 4, under mean difference, whatever the number is there, that number you have to add to 1327. So it becomes 1328. This 1328, you have to write it as 1.328 into 10 raised to the power. Whatever the characteristic is there will become the power of 10. Thus the number becomes 1.328 into 10 raised to the power 2, which is nothing but 132.8. Thus antilog of 2.1234 is 132.8. Antilog of 0.0013. In the row of 0.00, under the column 1, in antilogarithm tables, the number will be 1002. Note down that number 1002 separately. Then under mean difference, column number 3, the number is 1. This 1 you have to add to 1002. So it becomes 1003. This 1003, you have to write it as 1.003 into 10 raised to the power. In this case, 0 is characteristics, so 10 raised to the power 0 we have to write. Thus the number becomes 1.003 into 10 raised to the power 0, which is nothing but 1.003 into 1, or simply 1.003. Thus the value of antilog 0.0013 is 1.003. Now we shall learn antilog of negative non-integers. Antilog of -2.4. So this has to be written as -2, -0.4, +1 and -1. This -2 and this -1, together it becomes -3, and that has to be written as 3 bar. And the remaining 1 minus 0.4, it will become 0.6. So that has to be written after 3 bar. So antilog -2.4 becomes antilog 3 bar 0.6. After that, zeros can be introduced. Now after the decimal, we have 60. So in front of 60, that is in the row of 0.60, under the column 0, which number is there in the logbook under the antilogarithm table that you have to search? So there you will get 3981. That 3981, you have to write it as 3.981 into 10 raised to the power. So So what is characteristic here? Characteristic is minus 3. So minus 3 will become power. Thus antilog minus 2.4 is equal to 3.981 into 10 raised to the power minus 3. Next example, antilog minus 3.8. So this minus 3.8, we have to write it as minus 3 minus 0.8. Then we have to add plus 1 and then minus 1. This minus 3 and minus 1, together it becomes minus 4. That minus 4, we have to write it as 4 bar. What is remaining here? 1 minus 0.8. 1 minus 0.8 becomes 0.2. After the 4 bar, you have to write it as 0.2. And after that, zeros can be introduced if no numbers are there. Now, after the decimal, we have 20. So in front of 0.20, under the column 0, under antilogarithm tables, you have to search which number is there in the logbook. So there you will find 1585. So this 1585, you have to write it as 1.585. And after that into, after that 10, raised to the power minus 4. From where this minus 4 has come? This has come from the characteristic. So here characteristic is 4 bar. So that 4 bar, you have to write it as minus 4. Thus antilog minus 3.8 becomes 1.585 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. Next example, antilog minus 1.812. So this minus 1.812, you have to write it as minus 1 minus 0.812 plus 1 minus 1. This minus 1 and that last minus 1, together it becomes minus 2. That minus 2, you have to write it as 2 bar. What is remaining here? 1 minus 0.812. 1 minus 0.812 becomes 0.188. And that you have to write after the 2 bar. So antilog minus 1.812 has to be written as antilog 2 bar 0.188. After the decimal, you take 2 digits. Here we have 0.18. So that 0.18, in front of 0.18, or in the row of 0.18, under the column 8. Why 8? Because after 0.18, 8 is there. So in the row of 0.18, under the column 8, which number is there in the logbook? Under antilogarithm tables, you have to search. So there you will find 1542. This 1542, you have to write it as 1.542. Then you have to write multiply, then you have to write into 10 raised to the power. Raised to the power minus 2. This minus 2 has come from the characteristic, that is 2 bar. So if bar is there, it will become minus. Thus antilog minus 1.812 is equal to 1.542 into 10 raised to the power minus 2. We shall take one more example. Antilog minus 1.2345. So this has to be written as minus 1 minus 0.2345 plus 1 and minus 1. So this first minus 1 and last minus 1, together it becomes minus 2. That minus 2, you have to write it as 2 bar. And what is remaining here? 1 minus 0.2345. It becomes 0.7655. So that 0.7655, you have to write in front of 2 bar. So antilog minus 1.2345 becomes antilog 2 bar 0.7655. After the decimal, you take 2 digits. So here we have 76. So in front of 0.76, or in the row of 0.76, under the column 5. Why 5? Because after 0.76, we have 5 here. So in the row of 0.76, under the column 5, in the logbook, under antilogarithm tables, if you search the number, you will get 5821.
this 5821 you have to write separately. Then under the column 5 in mean difference. Why 5? Because after 0.765 there is one more number, that is 5. So under the column 5 in the mean difference, which number is there in the same row, you have to search. So there you will get 7. So that 7 you have to add to 5821. So 5821 plus 7 becomes 5828. This 5828 you have to write it as 5.828. Then into, then 10 raised to the power, whatever the characteristic is there. Here 2 bar is the characteristic, so this bar will become minus. So minus 2 will become power. Thus antilog minus 1.2345 is equal to 5.828 into 10 raised to the power minus 2.